was part of the record, so it happened during the making of the record. And
there are some songs that he
did. Yeah, so he did.
Half of the record still has Joey on, I think, five songs. When he left, the record changed. The way we played the songs, definitely, I mean, personally, the way I played changed, playing with different drummers. It's just different, you know, just something different, which is cool, and it was sad, but it's also inspiring for other people as well. I definitely think the record went a different direction, and I think we're really stoked on the outcome, so, things happen for a reason.
And I'd like to ask you, why did you guys decide to have so many artists doing your work, and how did that vision get in the picture?
Well, I don't think it was an intentional, like, we're going to get, you know, all these. We didn't even think of it that way. It was more or less just a coincidence in a lot of ways, you know. I know early on there was discussion of working with Trent, just because I think him and Josh had sort of a kindred sort of spirits, like going through the same experiences. When you've been doing this as long as you have, you know, sometimes it's good to talk to people who have, you know, these kind of experiences. And so it didn't work out because he was making a record as well, and which is, I can't wait to hear. But it was great that he was able to contribute because, you know, he did stuff that we wouldn't have thought of. And that's kind of the whole point, you know. With each one of these guests, there's an exchange, and you learn something. And they're coming into our world, more or less, but they're bringing something
from their world.
So it's a good, you know, relationship.
But I mean, Queens of the Stone Age and Trent Reznor and Alex Turner and those kind of artists, they make sense. Elton John, if you see, so.
And that's the whole reason why you put them in there, because sometimes you wonder why things make sense, and sometimes you make things make sense. And that one made actually a lot of sense. Not the idea of it, but the record, and I'm not even there, you know. But we played in the room together, and we worked it out together, and he got frustrated, we got frustrated, and it ended up being like one of the brighter days of making the record.
And on the note of unlikely collaborations, you also have Anthony Bourdain writing on the album sleeve.
I mean, we're all people love food, and I love him. we did his show once, you know, and that was probably one of the funner things we've ever done. You know, to dress up in Christmas sweaters and play non-existent Christmas. But I mean, we have a mutual respect, I think, going on, where he's a badass, and the way he wrote our bio, it's like we couldn't ask for something better, you know.
It's sort of the polish. I think, you know, this is my first record and things, but looking at the other records and the people that were involved, whether it's producer, engineer, or whatever, we're kind of friends and part of the same family. And I think on this record, we decided to take a risk and go outside and bring in a guy that we didn't know. I think so. I think that he has aesthetic. I think he's incredible. I think that has a relationship.
I know that the few times that I've played here, the crowds are always amazing. It's unfortunate, like, that I've never really had much time off here, because that's what we like to do. So yesterday we got the chance to walk around, and it was pretty amazing, actually, because not only the streets are paved with tiles and just walking on them seems strange, you know, coming from, you know, Los Angeles per se, mm-hmm. but like the activity that's going on in the streets and the people, it's a pretty lively scene.
Well, you guys are laughing. I feel that I sense that there's a history behind.
I
mean, there's a story or
there's
something.
There's a story there, you know. I mean,
you have to share.
I've had run-ins here with people on the street where, mm-hmm. yeah, there was almost violence. I don't want to get into the details, but yeah.
But this time, or
no, the last time, well, 10 years ago, yeah. But yesterday, we had an interesting day.
Oh, God, you have to tell us the story.
I would say that
I'll say I've never felt more hustled or people trying to hustle on me more than here. Yeah.
So
all
years,
day.
In 10 years, Portuguese people just became that much like bold.
Bold, yeah. I would say bold is a great word, and I'm not gonna say who, but one of our crew's phones got stolen in a very slick, like it was impressive how well the interplay between the two mm-hmm. characters who stole this phone. It was amazing to notice that they were hustling us, and they actually got away with something.
Yeah, so we're bold and sneaky.
But
they're
very charming, exactly. But I have respect for that because we think of ourselves as people who can like go on the street anywhere and like fit in and like stroll and meet with the people and hang. But I gotta say, I was very impressed with the hustle.
I'm not really sure if I should say I'm glad or
we're from a big city and there's hustling all the time, you know, and it's not really done with the kind of grace that you guys have.